And welcome again, dear friends, to the weekend edition of Fresh Bread. It is Saturday, December the 11th, 2021. Hey, I hope you're having a great week and that your weekend is being a very fruitful one in terms of just getting things done, relaxing. You know, we're 2 weeks away from Christmas Day. Christmas this year, of course, will be on Saturday. Most of us already pretty well know that if we've done any planning, of course. But, you know, we'll talk more about our Christmas memories and things in our subsequent editions and installments of Fresh Bread these next 2 weeks. I think we'll just do a little more reflecting on those, and we'll have some scripture passages, I would hope. But you know, again, it's such a great time of preparation, and I think to me that's really the key word. I don't think I've mentioned that this week, but if I was to use one word that describes Advent to me today, it's the word preparation. We're getting ready for something. And we've got to make way for it. When you're preparing for something, you're not just sitting there, right? If you're preparing for company, what are you doing? You're getting your house ready. You're getting stuff cleaned up. You're getting food in the refrigerator. You're getting the dinner made. We're preparing. We're getting ready for the arrival of Christ. Now, obviously, we know he came into the world as a baby, fully God, fully man, 2,000 years ago. And yet, we're now making room for him again. Every year at this time, we make room for Christ. We want to give him more of ourselves. We look at our lives, we go, Lord, is there any areas that we're not giving completely to you? And if that's the case, take those away. Show us those areas that we need to give to you. And then take the things that are in between me and you, Lord, take those away so I can come straight to you. I don't want anything in between us. It's like a husband and a wife. If you've got something in between you and your wife, you're going to have problems. And so you've got to reconcile that relationship. Well, Jesus came for us to reconcile ourselves to God, but you know, we have to be reconciled to Jesus too. And that means we've got to get rid of all the impurities, all the sins and things. And that's what the prophet Micah was talking about last Sunday in the scripture passage where we were reading about burning away the dross, burning away these impurities so that we're not going to be pure in front of God. So be that as it may, let's look at the last part of the scripture that we're going to get to this week. Hopefully we can finish up on this a little bit in the next week, but we've been looking at Luke chapter 1, and so now we've been told Zechariah got the vision that he and Elizabeth, who had not had children all their married life, now they're up in years, and they've kind of given up on having a child. They're beyond childbearing years. All of a sudden now the angel Gabriel comes and surprises Zechariah when he's burning incense in the temple, and he tells him, you're going to have a baby. And your wife is too. And Zechariah is just flabbergasted. He said, how's this going to be, you know? And of course, the angel Gabriel tells him, well, it's, you know, nothing's impossible with God, but since you didn't believe me, we're going to make you not talk for about 9 months. That's going to be your sign. This is about to happen. A little bit of a paraphraser, but that's basically what went on, I think. And then, of course, then Elizabeth is also, finds out when she is expectant that she says this, and she knows it's from the Lord. She says, this is the way the Lord has dealt with me in the days when he looked with favor upon me to take away my disgrace among men. So she knew that it was from the Lord. And we're going to just stop right there for today as we just kind of ponder upon these next few minutes as we wrap up Fresh Bread for this week and get ready for our third Sunday of Advent tomorrow on the 12th of December. Don't forget to come to church if you're possibly able to do so. We'll be having services at 9:30 at Oakland, at 11 at Kansas Avenue. We will have a Sunday school at 8:45 at Oakland, at 9:30 at Kansas Avenue. Then we're having short prayer time and Bible study at 3:30 on Sunday afternoons here at Oakland. About 4:20 or so, we wrap that up. I head over the bridge to go to Kansas Avenue. We get ready to watch The Chosen. We're closing in on the end of The Chosen, season one. And we're maybe going to show a double episode today because I think there's going to be a little chance maybe for some folks who may need to catch up on some of the prior episodes to be able to at least catch up on maybe a really pivotal one, episode 7, which is about 38 minutes long. So we'll probably run that around 4:30 today, and then we'll go right into the finale of season 1, the episode 8. So if you haven't been to any of them, please come. I'll tell you what, it's just been a phenomenal blessing. I don't know how else to explain it. I've never seen anything like it, The Chosen. And it is a worldwide phenomenon. And a lot of people, it's all pretty much word of mouth. Highly recommend that you come. I'm not begging you. I'm not going to beg you, but I would highly recommend that you come, even if you're starting out. We're also going to do what they call Binge Jesus. That was kind of their slogan for The Chosen. We're going to watch all episodes from the introduction all the way through episode 8 for season 1. We're looking at a date to do that. I'm thinking right now, very likely we're going to do that starting in the afternoon of Christmas Eve and just roll it all the way through to our watch night service. It'll take about, I'm estimating now, to watch all 8 of those would take somewhere in the neighborhood of about 4 hours. So you don't have to watch all of them. You can come watch some, leave, come back, and we'll still be showing them, and we're just going to run one after the other. And so that's the plan. And it could change, but somewhere around the 2 o'clock on Christmas Eve, or Christmas Eve, on New Year's Eve. Christmas Eve is going to be different. We're going to have our candlelight service at 4 here at Oakland and 6 o'clock over here at Kansas Avenue. But for New Year's Eve, we do the watch night service as we give God thanks for this year. And we look forward to all of the blessings that He's got for us for the coming year. And so it's a great service, the watch night service. We're watching for Jesus to come, could return at any time, but we're also watching and waiting for God to come in the sense of His blessings and what He wants to give to us and what He wants to do through us. So come expecting a miracle, as Oral Roberts used to have on the basketball court down there at Oral Roberts University. Expect a miracle. And it's a great slogan, and I believe we should all expect a miracle because God is still able to perform the same miracles that He did back in these days of the Bible. He's still able to do them today. So, again, a time of expectation. Here now, Elizabeth is expecting a child. We know Mary has been visited by the angel Gabriel, as we read into the next few verses here, Luke 26 to 38, where we read that Gabriel then goes to Galilee in the city, the town of Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to be married to a man named Joseph. And he says, "Hail, favored one, the Lord is with you." And she was greatly troubled at this statement, kept pondering what kind of situation this might be. And the angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and have a bear a son. You shall name him Jesus. He'll be great and be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And his kingdom will have no end." And Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I'm a virgin?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. For that reason, the holy offspring shall be called the Son of God. Behold, even your relative Elizabeth has also conceived a son in her old age, and she who is called barren is now in her 6th month. For nothing." Listen to this, verse 37, chapter 1 of Luke. Underline it, put it on your mirror at home, on a sticky note, whatever you want to say. "For nothing will be impossible with God." Amen. True then is true today. Mary said, "Behold, the bondslave of the Lord, be it done to me according to your word." And the angel departed from her. Well, friends, that's it. We went a little long today. I just couldn't help but share that with you today as we wrap up. That's probably as far as we'll go in Luke 1. Again, if you will read 2 chapters of Luke a day for about the next 5-6 days, or even 3, you'll be caught up right away. You could just read all of them, because today would be Luke 11, and you can read one a day after that. So just read up to Luke 11 today if you want to get caught up. And then go and read one chapter of Luke a day all the way till Christmas Eve. I think we did that 2 years ago. It was great. A lot of people did it. It was a blessing. I would encourage us to do it again this year. I didn't really mention it until I think earlier this week. So, hey, it's never too late, right? So let's get on this idea of spending time with the Lord through scripture, through prayer, through Bible study, through meditation, through fellowship. These are ways that God's going to really bless us in this beautiful time of year that we know is Advent and the Christmas season. God's got great things in store for you, good things in store for me, great things in store for the church, but we got to go through the doors when He opens them. Amen. So let's be ready for the blessings that God has for us. Well, friends, thank you so much for being with me today for this extended version of Fresh Bread, back to our 10-minute time frame that we've been doing in the past. Hey, hope to see you in church tomorrow, God willing, on Sunday. Until then, have a great rest of the day. God bless you.